Our soccer weekly update from GoJacks.com. Delaney Grant, the senior defender from Omaha, is with us. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. How neat was it on Sunday to put the ball in the back of the net and get that so highly anticipated goal, because it felt like just been waiting to get one in the back of the net and everything would kind of go the right way from there, and it finally happened. Tell me about that.
Yeah, it definitely was a highly awaited moment with all the ties that we've had in the previous games, but honestly, I didn't really feel nervous. Like, our culture has been centered around like being confident in who you are and playing to your ability, and so I went in and was confident and was able to finish it, so yeah.
Describe in more detail the actual goal itself.
So, left-footed corner, which honestly was kind of crazy because not used to playing with my left foot. Normally would say I'm a right-footed dominant player, but in those moments you kind of just have to step up and do what's best for the team, so yeah. Super cool. Bounced off the goalie, went in, so crazy.
Worked out beautifully, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
What are you majoring in?
English education. So I'm actually student teaching this semester at the high school here in town.
And what do you want to do after college?
Definitely probably going to pursue teaching. Maybe eventually get my master's and then work into something athletic director related, something like that. So, yeah.
You want to work high school, college?
Definitely high school. I think I had such a good high school experience, so I want to kind of mimic that in the future, I guess.
That's awesome. A lot of things happening on Sunday beyond just that win. You have hometown heroes. You honor some wonderful people. You have the pride there performing. You have great turnout. Sunday was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think our community is like a big reason why we have such a long unbeaten streak at home. Just like the amount of support that we can get at our games and the pride is such a big, like, everyone's so upbeat when they come. So, yeah, definitely a super cool experience.
All right, now a challenging way to end this year. You have four of your last six away from Brookings.
Yeah, I think people are kind of excited, though, because being home all of September, we do kind of get the urge to, like, get out of Brookings a little bit, maybe get some wins on the road for sure. So,
Brock Thompson, Jackrabbit soccer coach with us now, and Delaney really got you going on Sunday. We've been talking about this a lot, all these ties and trying to kind of just get the ball rolling. And it seemed like once she found the back of the net, everything sort of just rolled downhill from there.
Yeah, absolutely. Obviously, you know, Delaney's played in some big moments for us, but she's also had some moments where she's been in a reserve role. And for her to get that goal, I think just symbolizes a little bit of what our team's about, is we have a team full of people that can make plays when their opportunity is given. And a really unique thing, and she alluded to it, is, you know, she took that corner with her left foot because an in-swinger with the wind is going to be much more dangerous, and she's not a left-footed player. And so that speaks really highly of the confidence she has in her own ability, and I'm really proud of her.
Let's talk about your two contests at home this past week in detail. Let's start with Friday. And it's amazing just the different way things can feel. You know, certain ties feel a certain way, certain ties feel a different way. That was a heck of a soccer game on Friday with Denver, and neither team scores, but I think both teams came away happy in many respects, even though they didn't win, because of the quality of competition. Would you agree?
Sure, absolutely. I thought it was a very high-level soccer game. Great pace to it. Some moments where you were under the gun a little bit. Some moments where you created chances to score. I think you said it very well. I think we felt like we could have won that game. I'm sure Denver felt the same way. It felt like there were a couple plays where we were fortunate not to lose it. But the reality of it is I'm really proud of the performance that we put in, and I thought that was one of the best performances we've had up until that point in the season.
And then on Sunday, we alluded to it, you're scoreless at the half, then Delaney scores, and it just seems like everything from that point on went your way, and 3-0 really isn't indicative of how tightly, especially the first half, was played.
Yeah, you know, Omaha's always been a team that's been very organized defensively, that makes it hard to score. They make it very hard to score. They're very hard to score on, and the first half was playing out that way, and, you know, and it's one of those things where when you get to goal, I feel like it changes the complexion of the game, and we've been in a few games over the past couple of weeks where we haven't had that goal, and so there's a different sense of pressure to it. The space to attack is still very compact and small, and it's harder and harder to score goals as the game kind of goes on and on against teams that are very organized defensively. And so when you get a goal, it opens up things up a little bit, and I thought you saw that against Omaha.
And your defense, it should be acknowledged, doesn't matter who the goalkeeper is. You know, you rotate through them. Doesn't matter who's playing in the back line. Because of the team and the way you guys come together, it's tough to score on you regardless of who the specific personnel has been.
Yeah, I'm really proud of the way our team's defended. That's more than a goalkeeping thing. It's more than a defender thing. It's really a collective mindset that our team has. And we talk a lot about wanting to be the best team in the country in the moment the ball is lost. We talk a lot about how our attacking decisions impact, how easy or hard it is for us to defend. And I think our team has been in a very good spot as far as just doing the right things in those moments and making it as easy as it possibly can. Obviously, against good teams, it's still hard to get the ball back, but I feel like we've committed to it, and you're starting to see that play out.
Well, it's interesting because we talk so much about how you had this lengthy homestand. You're going to be home for all this time, and now it's in the rearview mirror. And now you have four of your last six on the road. So all that work you've done to be battle-tested, to prepare yourself for adversity, it will be put to the test here the next few weeks.
For sure. You know, that was the message to the team this morning. It's a bigger challenge to go on the road and play well and get results. There's always different sets of adversity. It could be things as simple as, you know, we're going to go on Friday, we're going to play on a turf field instead of playing on a grass field. It's going to play a little bit different. And, I love this team, and I love when we face a little bit of adversity. I think our team is ready to kind of get away from home. There's some bonding that happens. There's actually a few easier things that take place on road trips as far as everybody on the same schedule and stuff. And so we're kind of due for some time away. I think that will help us. But the challenge on the field will certainly be greater, and we're going to play two very good teams this weekend.
Let's give sort of a rough sketch of the two teams you're going to see. And again, two teams that are kind of looking forward to having you come. There's a bullseye on your back because of the success you've had.
Absolutely, and that's also the way conference games play out. Is anytime you see a designation of a Summit League soccer game, you know that you're going to get the team's best. You know that they're going to prepare. We've got to be prepared to expect the unexpected. That could be a unique set piece. It could be a change in formation. But you know for sure it's going to be high energy. It's going to be max effort, and it's going to be a high level of desire from the team that's going to be across from us on both of these days.